o'clock, so we'll call this a meeting to order. This is the January meeting of the City of Greensburg Board of Aviation Commissioners. We meet every fourth Monday of the month, and we'll begin with roll call from our secretary, Judy.
Bill Ernstis?
Present.
Jim Pruitt?
Here.
Horace Reese?
Here.
Don Whipple?
Absent.
John Doolittle?
Here. I spoke with Don Whipple this week, and he's unable to be here today. So, next it takes us to our agenda approval. If you'll take a moment, look over the agenda. Have any discussion with the agenda before we give it its approval? If there's no discussion, we'll I'll entertain a motion to accept the agenda.
So moved.
Moved by Bill.
Awesome.
Second by Jim. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Okay. Cruz, 4-0 by voice vote. We have the minutes from their December meeting. We'll hold on a second. So next on the agenda is our approval, reading and approval of the minutes from December. They're brief enough. Judy, if you'll read those, please.
City of Greensburg, Indiana, Board of Aviation Commissioners, Tuesday, December 27, 2016. President John Dooley called the meeting to order at 7 p.m. Board members present were John Dooley, Bill Ernstis, Don Whipple, and Jim Pruitt. Jerry Scheidler, airport manager, was also present. Board member Horace Reese and BF&S representative Paul Shaffer were absent. Judy Kurd performed the duties of secretary. The meeting agenda was reviewed. Bill Ernstis made a motion to approve the agenda as presented. Don Whipple seconded the motion. The motion passed unanimously by voice vote 4-0. Judy Kurd read the November 28, 2016 minutes. Don Whipple made a motion and Jim Pruitt seconded a motion to approve the November 28 minutes as read. The motion passed unanimously by voice vote 4-0. Bill Ernstis read the financial report. Old business. Title VI training program. John Dooley noted that the Title VI training program is not yet available on the web. New business. Internal control video and signoff. John Dooley noted that all board members have viewed the Title IV training video. Jim Pruitt needs to send in his signoff sheet. U.S. Fish and Wildlife Permits. Bill Ernstis reported that the BOAC has applied for and received a U.S. Fish and Wildlife Permit. It was necessary to obtain the permit to allow airport personnel to control wildlife, mainly birds, that may endanger aircraft during takeoff or landing at the airport. Bill also noted that they will file the necessary activity report each month. There was no report from Paul Shaffer of BF&S. Approval of bills. The bills were presented for approval. Don Whipple made a motion to approve the payment of bills as presented. Bill Ernstis seconded the motion. The motion passed unanimously by roll call vote 4-0. Bill also noted that it will be necessary to move $1,000 from the professional services account to the airport manager account to correct an error. Jim Pruitt made the motion and Don Whipple seconded the motion to move $1,000 from professional services account to airport manager account. The motion passed unanimously by roll call vote 4-0. Comments from the board and or public. John Dooley reminded the board that the board will need to elect officers at the January 2017 meeting. There were no other comments from the board or public. Meeting adjournment and next meeting date. There being no further business before the board, Bill Ernstis made a motion and Jim Pruitt seconded the motion to adjourn the meeting. The motion passed unanimously by voice vote 4-0, and President John Dooley adjourned the meeting at 7:18 p.m. The next meeting will be moved to Monday, January the 23rd, 2016, at City Hall at 7 p.m.
A few corrections, I think 2017.
Okay, correct.
I'll make that the other one on internal control video, and in the body of that, you've got the Title IV training video, if that's the internal control training video.
So that's six.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, under new business. In other words, the Title VI is under old business. That's okay, but under new business, the internal control video should state in the body, noted that all board members have viewed the internal control video.
For Title VI. Oh, take out Title IV, and just put internal control.
It's not a Title IV or Title VI, it's just internal control. With those changes, any discussion on the minutes? If not, with those changes, those corrections, I'll entertain a motion to accept the minutes as changed.
And I'll move to accept the minutes as changed.
Okay, Jim moves, and for a second.
Second.
Bill seconds. All in favor say aye. I guess, Horace, you weren't here. You had me gone. Yeah. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. So it approved 3-0. Takes us to the financial report for the airport. Bill?
Airport improvement is $8,733.45. Urban fuel fund, $80,550.20. Airport operational fund, $170,867.67, for a total of $260,151.32. And at the first of the year, we had $35,777.66 of fuel on hand.
Are there any comments from that? If not, we'll move on to old business. We've touched on those. There's the two different training videos, the Title VI training video and the internal controls. And I think, has everybody done the internal controls? That little, well, you have not yet. It's a little 27-minute video. There's also the Title VI video, and then there's a form to sign off on each one that you viewed it, and they want those turned in. I guess they're getting pressure on their end to get these things turned in. So if you need help with that, I've got information as far as how to access those videos and get her done.
I called here, and she told me they weren't available.
Yeah, they weren't for a while, but now they are. The Title VI, the internal controls was available, has been for some time, but just in the last few weeks, the Title VI is now available. I'll give you some written information how to access that one. Okay. It takes us to new business. Just briefly here, the 2017 schedule for the airport board meetings, they will all fall on the fourth Monday of the month as regularly scheduled, except again for this coming December. Christmas will fall on Monday, so we'll meet on Tuesday the 26th. Otherwise, the calendar, the setting for the meetings will be just like it always is, the fourth Monday of every.
Are you sure that Tuesday is not a holiday?
I believe I think it's just going to be on the Monday. I think everybody's back to business as normal.
I'm pretty sure the courthouse is closed.
Yeah, maybe.
In fact, I'm almost positive.
Yeah.
So
I won't be here because I'm going to be in Phoenix for Christmas.
Gotcha. Okay.
Fact is, every Christmas.
Okay. As long as City Hall is open, I mean, we would normally have that on Tuesday. So.
I'm just saying, the courthouse is taking the 26th. I guess it's their Christmas. I don't know.
It's probably their Christmas Eve is what they're taking it for, taking it.
Yeah, you know, City Hall will be open on Tuesday?
I have no idea.
No idea?
All right.
It's a year in advance, isn't it, Mayor?
I would rather take off Friday, but that's okay. That way we only have 2 days of trash.
Well, we'll leave that up in the air. Obviously, we got time to
change. Okay, I'll let you know.
if necessary. I want to back up a little bit too, the roll call, under, certainly not in the roll call, but I want to make note in the minutes that our airport manager, Jerry Scheider, Mayor Dan Manis, and from BF&S, Paul Shaffer are in attendance to be, if not, not as roll call members, but I don't think it's being here. Let's go on to the next item of new business. It's the Qtpod Fuel Terminal Service Agreement. And I had a copy of that that I don't have with me today, but basically it's, Jerry, you know a little bit about it. If you want to discuss, they have, it's our service agreement with our credit card reader at the airport for fuel. And they have three different levels you pay for an annual service agreement. And long story short, we're recommending Jerry's recommending the middle of the two service agreements. It's a fee of $995. The reason we recommended that is it also includes, Jerry, you know a little bit about it,
it includes free software upgrades, which we know we'll have one this year. And if we don't, we have to pay $950 for this software upgrade, but it's free if we have the service plan, which is only $45 more. And the service plan also gives us like 40% off parts, and we can call them free of charge instead of paying their hourly fee to talk to them on the phone and so on. So I recommend go ahead and get that.
They had a lesser level and a more expensive level. But we're going to be on the hook for the $950 anyway.
What's the more expensive?
More expensive one was what, $1,595?
Like we just went open like that too long ago.
Well, we did it last year.
Well, that was a year ago. Yeah, they had a more expensive level for $1,595 that would include.
I think parts were covered at a higher level.
Yeah.
Other than that, it's about the same.
And then they had a lesser level that really didn't cover much of anything, and you'd still have to pay for your upgrades of your software.
You still have to pay your software upgrade if you had a lower level.
Well, I guess I'll move to, I move that we accept the middle level of the service agreement.
I'll second.
We got a motion and a second. Any further discussion before we go on? Okay, we have a motion and a second. No further discussion. We will take a roll call vote, Judy, on paying for the $995 service agreement for the Qtpod fuel terminal service.
Bill Erstis?
Yes.
Jim Pruitt?
Yes.
Boris Reese?
Yes.
John Dooley?
Yes. Next item, just contact information. I put on everybody's desk there. If you want to review that, make sure what I've got there for you is proper as far as contact information for board members, airport manager, and so on. Just like to update that once a year, make sure I've got everything on that. Anybody have any changes to make to that, or is that kosher so far? Okay. We'll go on to the next item of new business, the election of the board officers for 2017. Under Indiana Code, the Board of Aviation Commissioners elects their officers from amongst themselves in the January meeting of every year, the first meeting of every year. Like I said, in the December meeting, I think there's some value that I'm not going to be present this coming year. I think there's some value in having other people participate in that. So I'll step down as president for this year, but we'll need to discuss who you'd like to be for your president for the 2017 year, starting with the February meeting.
Well, I'll nominate Bill Erstis for the position of president.
We have a nomination for Bill. Anything else? Anybody else? Further discussion or other nominations? If not, I'll close the nominations. Let's vote, just a voice vote. All in favor of Bill?
Second.
Oh, you need a second.
I'll second.
Boris will second. And we'll go by a just voice vote. All in favor of Bill Ernst serving as the 2017 president, say aye.
Aye.
Okay. It's 4-0. And he'll start up with the February meeting then. And we need a vice president also. VP. It's up to the board.
I'll nominate John Dooley.
Boris,
I'll second.
Any other nominations or in the second?
Pruitt second.
Pruitt second. Morris nominated.
You
21st.
Any other discussions? No? If not, let's take a voice vote. All in favor of John Dooley being the vice president, say aye.
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 Okay. That'll take us to our engineering firm, Butler Fairman Seifert, Paul Shaffer.
Thank you. Happy 2017. Sorry I missed the last meeting. Like Ori said, I was doing some Christmas with family out of town in Wisconsin, so I hope you all had happy holidays. We've got a few items on the agenda for this evening. The first item is the closeout of AIP number 31-11 there. And that is the taxiway preservation overlay that was completed. And this is the final pavement and all the closeout documents that, this is more of a reporting item. Dr. Dooley signed those and we got that all submitted to the FAA. So as soon as they accept that closeout document, you should receive $21,600 from the FAA and $1,200 from the state. And that will then conclude that project and we can close that. Are there any questions on that? Any concerns?
No, just a comment. I guess Andrew Maximovich from BF&S said that we should get the federal money, I guess, within a few days and the state money within a few weeks.
Sure.
At least what he anticipates. So that's money we've already spent. We're just being reimbursed for that grant.
Yes.
Do we, is there anything we need to do on that?
No, this is just a reporting item. Just reporting it's.
And you had already approved that pay request back when we first submitted it. This is just the official closeout action. The next item is approval of the CIP capital improvement plan. And I passed out a packet to you all. And this document gets updated annually. It's the five-year program. This particular one is very similar to what we had approved last year. The major change is if you look on the second page of the cover letter, that water line extension for fire service at the airport, we changed that funding type to a type two project, which means state and local project from a FAA project. As I dug into that a little bit, that project was not going to compete well for the federal dollar. And there's some questions on whether a general aviation is even eligible for utility services to be funded by the feds. So we thought a better strategy to put it in a type two, which is the state and local. I have another handout I'll pass out after we talk about the CIP that talks about that state and local program. Right now, we don't have any money in it. There hasn't been money in that for quite some time. But there is legislation this session that supports funding for that. And we'll go through after we get done talking about this. I can explain that. But other than that, in the CIP, the document is virtually the same as it was last year. I've just gone through and updated the pricing to be reflective of the 2016 bids that were in. So the construction cost, material cost, those sorts of things got updated. The land values were also adjusted based on the current comparables of what's on the market in Decatur County for those types of parcels right now. So we've updated the prices per acre. Of course, these are all just budgetary numbers right now, just to give the Indiana Department of Transportation and the FAA an idea of what the project budget would be. So the primary focus, of course, is the runway 19, the new runway. And assuming this document makes the assumption that the environmental is approved in fiscal year 2017, so we can proceed forward. From there, it goes on to the land purchase for that runway and then the construction of the runway. And that pretty much consumes the entire five-year CIP. And, you know, as we said, it's a planning document, so these things ebb and flow. The reality of getting all this money in 5 years is probably not very realistic. But we want to capture the project in its entirety here. So if they'll fund as much as they possibly can, and then whatever's left over just gets rolled in the following years. So, but that is the bulk of your CIP. You'll notice in on all the land acquisition projects, we have identified those as type 1 or type 2 funding. And so the type 1 funding would be straight federal funding, but that takes a little while to get on their radar. So we've also put it in as a type 2 type project, which is that state funding pot again, which just gives us another option. That would be a state 50-50 program where you pay half and the state pays half, and then at such time, if the FAA were to reimburse it, then they would reimburse your share only up to 90%. So we've got some history doing that in the past. But otherwise, the document should look pretty familiar, pretty much the same thing as what we did last January. Are there any questions on this? It does need to be approved this evening. The due date is February.
Bill moves we approve the CIP. Other discussion or questions for Paul about that?
We need an authorization for the president to sign.
Or that could be a part of the approval process, you know, approval and signature approval.
I move we approve and John sign.
So we've got that approval. Any other discussion?
I'll second.
Horace will second. Anything else before we take a vote? If not, we'll go by a roll call vote. Judy, please. And this is a motion to approve the CIP and authorize the president's signature for the document.
Bill Erstis?
Yes.
Jim Pruitt?
Yes.
Horace Reese?
Yes.
John
Dooley? Yes. So that passes 4-0.
Thank you very much. I have a handout here that talks about that state funding here that kind of dovetails in the CIP. So if you don't mind, I'll take a couple minutes to explain this legislation. So this legislative session is a big session for Indiana. There's several bills of infrastructure orientation. This aviation bill is a House Bill 1280 that's been introduced by Representative Holly Sullivan down near Evansville. But what it's trying to do is it creates an airport development grant fund. And it does not raise any new taxes for the state. It simply takes the existing sales tax collected on aircraft sales, which is estimated up to $4.8 million annually, and then the excise tax that's currently charged on aviation fuels of 10 cents per gallon right now. Excise taxes. It takes both of those pots of money and moves it into a grant fund. So then what those funds would be used for is the typical match on the 95 and 5 AIP projects, where we know that the CIP we just approved has only a 4% match in there for NDOT. NDOT's match has been bouncing around because right now the line item in the budget fluctuates from year to year, and so this is trying to give them some consistency. So I won't go down through all these talking points, but the second item of what the fund would do would be whatever money's left over would establish the 50-50 program again. The last time that program was active was when Build Indiana funds were being put into that fund, but it hasn't been funded since. So this would take and put that. So projects that you would use it for might be your land acquisition or the fire service to the airport. So it's a big benefit to Indiana. It helps make the match more consistent. It also will help us leverage more federal dollars into the state, because when the feds are programming, they take a look at the ability to match grants. So if they believe that you can only match $40 million in grants, then they'll only give you $40 million. But if you have the ability to match $80 million, then there's a possibility you can get more. Indiana, our amount of money is bounced around from $60 to $75 million annually coming into the state on FAA grants. So that's money that we don't get if the match isn't available. And also, this program would help position projects to advance faster and get more FAA funds. For example, buying your land, that would help position your project. It also would fund revenue-generating projects such as fuel systems and hangars and things that the FAA doesn't like to pay for, but are very important to local communities, because the more revenue you can generate at your airport will reduce your burden on the local tax rolls. And so this is very important. If we can get those taxes in there and we can help our airports become more self-sustaining, it's an important thing. And we can reduce our phasing and our projects. So the return for the state, you know, aviation's a big business, $14 billion annually. In Indiana, companies use that are impacted by aviation. So those are all the spinoff jobs and the employees of people who are engaged or use aviation. And then basically it helps promote business development by allowing the corporate teams. It also allows the executive and technical support of a lot of our products that we manufacture here. So one way to think of that is aviation makes the sales and maintains the sales and makes sure that the technical support is there for Indiana products so that the trucks can be filled and they can ship them out on the roadway. So without aviation, the demand for road transportation goes down, the demand for manufacturing goes down. So, and we also have a lot of need for pilots, and aviation managers and so forth. And we have three great state organizations that educate people in aviation, and by investing in aviation, it's going to provide a better future for those students as well. So that's kind of a high-level summary. There is a complementary bill called House Bill 1002, which deals all with roads, and the concept there is they're using some sales tax, gas tax, and all these things that are currently in place, but they're raising them all. So it's a much bigger bill. It's a $1 billion bill by year five. Aviation is pretty small potatoes when it compares to that. So we're hoping that this will get some traction and go on through, and it's in support of the overall transportation picture. So Wednesday, there'll be a legislative day for Aviation Association. We're inviting all the senators and reps to come and to hear about the aviation needs in Indiana. We would encourage you to take these talking points, reach out to your rep and to your senator, if nothing less, with the message of support House Bill 1280. So we can make sure aviation gets properly funded. So, any questions on those legislative opportunities for aviation?
Homie, am I thinking right here that if this bill were to pass, then we could possibly use some of this money toward land acquisition?
Right, that's exactly right, Jim. So let's just say, for example, we get our full ask, and we've got roughly $6 million in an annual budget. Well, the current need for INDOT to match at $80 million of federal money would be $4 million. So we'd have this $6 million, or you'd have $6 million, so we'd have an extra $2 million. And then they would take applications for those projects. And Greensburg might get, you know, let's say $500,000 towards a land acquisition project. Yeah, that's the concept, is they would use those $2 million extra to pass out to airports. Okay. Thank you very much for your time. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Paul. That will take us to the next item on the agenda, the payment of the bills. We'll review those first. Everybody has a copy there in front of them. I looked over the bills. I didn't see anything out of the ordinary here. Some payroll-related bills, workman's comp, Medicare, FICA, phone bill. Billers, this is moved that we pay them.
I'll second.
Jim will second that we pay them. Good. A motion and a second. Any further discussion before we take a vote? If there's no further discussion, we'll take a roll call vote to pay these bills as listed. I do want to list, by the way, before we go on, the clerk treasurer did add one more here for us. It's a reimbursement bill for, I don't know if we need to do that in a separate motion. It's basically a $99.96 bill. It was just added on. Jerry Scheider has this one to reimburse for an expense he had for a mini light bar for the lawnmower. Should we do that as a separate entity? Let's just, you know what, let's do that. Yeah. Let's vote on our bills as listed first. Let's do that.
I was going to say, is that included in the bills?
No, it's a late add-on that the clerk treasurer just
gave. Well, no, I understand. I mean, we're reimbursing here. We're just already,
right,
already paid for it. So.
Right. All right, but we'll do the bills as listed first, then we'll deal with that second. Let's do that. So we'll take a roll call vote for the bills as listed.
Thanks. Bill Ursus?
Yes.
Jim Brook?
Yes.
Horace Reese?
Yay.
John Dooley?
Yes.
John, you know I always ask the same question.
Yep.
Why did it not get on there in time?
I'm sure Jerry can answer that. It's a bill he acquired here in January.
I took it to the clerk's office. Too late to get it on there, I guess. I wouldn't expect it to be on the next month, so.
You know where I always come from.
It's a reimbursement bill for just less than, again, $99.96. That's something you spend out of your pocket, is that right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, is that something we need to vote on this month?
The clerk treasurer gave it to us here for consideration tonight.
I presume that it's already been paid.
Yes.
You haven't been paid yet.
Yeah. It says Jerry brought this in today for a reimbursement. Would you please approve with other bills tonight at the meeting? Thanks, Stacy Martin. That's in the packet here as we come in today. So it's for the board to do as they see fit on that one. You can approve or defer.
How do we train him?
Just go over there and beat him.
Beat on the ear.
He's right over there. Yeah, he was saying he didn't expect it until next month. Stacy Martin.
Well, I mean, I
added it on for tonight.
I guess my problem is that not to pay it, but it's just, I mean, why do we get this as a separate bill instead of what we're normally?
it was a late, the other bills had already been listed.
I understand that, but I mean, it's just like.
That's just how she presented it, so, again, the board can do as they please, it's up to the board.
I guess we could ask her now, if she's got the list already made up, and anything comes in, just put it on the next one. Now, Jerry, if you need money from Brent or something, let me know, I'll help you.
I paid on credit card, I haven't paid for it yet either.
So it's up to you guys.
I think it's just cleaner, if Jerry expected it next month, let's get it for him next month.
I'll do it next month, then.
Okay, any other opinions?
Well, it's not that I'm trying to hold the money back, because I'm sure it's a legitimate bill, and I'm sure we're gonna pay it, it's just a matter of when.
Yeah.
Yeah, what was presented, I mean, it's, yeah, laid out on, it's presented here tonight, it's not like you're gonna review it last week anyway, so, I mean, I would be in favor of paying it just to get it over with and done with, out of the way, but, and Morris would rather do otherwise, but it's up to you, it's up to the board, however you wanna handle this.
I'll move that we pay the bill.
Okay, we have Jim moving to pay.
I'll second.
And Bill will second, further discussion?
And I'll vote yes. It's just a matter of principle.
What's on here? Any further discussion? No, we'll take a roll call vote.
Bill Ernstus?
Yes.
Jim Pruitt?
Yes.
Horace Reeves?
Yes.
John Dooley?
Yes. Jerry, you can eat this up. Okay. Well, that takes care of the listed bills and the additions. Do we have any comments here from the board tonight?
Yeah, I've got one. In the newspaper the other day, there was an article about Stellar City of North Vernon, and something was mentioned, not Greensburg necessarily, but by the mayor of North Vernon, Mayor Mike O-C-H-S. He said, before it was never possible for big industries to come in and look at our area, he said. Now, with the bigger airport, they are able to come in and scout us out. So I just thought I'd mention that too, so when we get a bigger airport, we'll have a lot of scouts coming in.
All right. Any other comments from board members?
I just want to ask her, yes. Girl Scouts or Boys?
Indian Scouts.
Comments from the public? Anybody have anything they'd like to offer up to the board? If not, I'd like to thank everybody for being here tonight. I've got the time, it's 7:38. We'll adjourn this meeting tonight. We'll meet again on February 27th. Bill will take over as president at that time. And yes, we'll take a motion. Jim motions.
No, second.
4 seconds.
Third.
Everybody in favor say aye.
Aye.
We're adjourned.